So thank you, Rainer, for this introduction. Now we'll be talking to you about recommendation 3 and 4, that is to say technology transfer and cooperation with third parties. Me and my colleague Tom Withenell will be with you for the next 10 to 15 minutes. So first, a brief overview of the presentation. We'll be telling you about the APO and tech transfer, what we are doing, why we are doing it, and how. And then I will be telling you about our activities, initiatives, about corporations with third parties. Now, over to Tom for technology transfer. Tom?
Super. Thank you, Enrico, and welcome, everybody. So I'd like to, as Enrico mentioned, I'd like to start by just covering the sort of the what, whys, and hows of the EPO getting involved in technology transfer. And I'd like to start by really questioning what is technology transfer. Everybody has a different definition. So this is what we at the EPO are using. We're saying that technology transfer is the movement of an innovation or technology from one unit to another unit for the purposes of commercialization. This unit can be an individual person, it can be an organization. Essentially, the movement happens because the initial organization is usually not able to commercialize. This could be through lack of resources, a lack of a mandate. Essentially, they move the technology to another organization who is able to commercialize it. Why are we doing it? Universities and also public research organizations are actually very important actors for innovation in Europe. And we feel that there are many innovations that really never quite get going. And we want to really push this and help them. This chart here shows the applications from last year. This is the applications the European Patent Office by the applicant type. And you can see that approximately 1 in 4 of these are coming from universities, SMEs, individual inventors, and public research organizations. So it really is a very important part of the innovation landscape. One thing we'll point out is that we have noticed that the number of applications from universities and public research organizations has halved since last year. Our chief economist unit is looking into this just to really find out what the reasons are. However, we're aware that there has been a global pandemic, which will certainly influence things. And additionally, many times there's sort of a blurred line between universities and SMEs as to really who is the one who's actually becoming the applicant. In many cases, universities or public research organizations actually do research on behalf of small companies, and then the applicant is in the name of the company, or some successful research has happened and is licensed out to another company, i.e. the tech transfer process has happened, and then the patent application goes in. Additionally, it's part of our mission statement. So as part of the EPO, we want to foster innovation, competitiveness, and economic growth. And the point I really want to make with this slide is that innovation does not end at the point the patent is granted. There's more steps to go, and technology transfer is an important part of this, really, to make sure that these patents are valorized. We want to get these patents not just to sit on a shelf gathering dust, but to actually be out there in the commercial space being commercialized. So how to do it? Now, I guess most of you know about the fact the Patlib Summit that happened in Porto about 2.5 years ago, and indeed maybe many of you were there. This was before my time at the EPO. There was a list of seven recommendations were created, and myself and Enrico today are going to talk about recommendations 3 and 4, which are really quite closely interlinked. So recommendation 3 covers the facilitation of technology transfer and really sort of the commercialization of innovative ideas. And recommendation 4 is covering the cross-network exchanges. Now, obviously, these two are quite close. It's very difficult to transfer technology without a network. And with a network, really, you need to have the commercialization input to make it happen. So I'd just like to talk briefly about the technology transfer activities, which we at the EPO are doing. We've recently had an external expert study on the technology transfer landscape, across Europe. And really came up with some quite interesting conclusions for that, particularly the involvement of the Patlib centers to really help push technology transfer. We'd like to engage best practices. I put best in brackets here because in many cases, there is no best practice because there are many different situations. There are many different options. There's no one size fits all, but it's really good to actually communicate with each other, work out what's there, and really have a toolkit of practices which are possible for any given situation. And following from that, it's obviously identifying training needs. We want to help you to be the best, and that helps comes with training. Additionally, we're going to continue our participation in technology transfer related events and also try and expand this. Obviously, with the pandemic, this has been rather difficult to relate, but certainly there are many online events. And as soon as we've got sort of face-to-face contact again, we really want to increase our participation in the EPO sort of status and awareness within these events. We also want to bring you, the PatLibs, closer to the tech transfer offices. Now, many technology transfer offices are based in universities, and a lot of the time, there's very similarities and overlaps with the work that you all do. So we really want to get together, bring each other closer, so we can just, again, share practices and improve. I'll move on to the Customer Discovery Program. This is a new program which we want to spearhead. In essence, the idea is to try and find customers for innovation as soon as possible. Now, there are many great innovations, many great technologies that push through and are developed, but ultimately there's actually no customer base for them at the end. So what we want to do is find a way of really getting to see, are there customers for this technology at a very early stage? We're also looking to knowledge share platforms. Now, these knowledge share platforms, they do exist. Essentially, it's a kind of matchmaking service for technology transfer. So we have various stakeholders. So they're either looking for or trying to promote their technologies. Now, many universities have these in a way of sort of a technology offer page on the website. But there are very few operating on a much larger scale. Some examples that we have found, of course, is the Enterprise Europe Network, who run a European platform, which is similar to this, also helping look for distributors. But also there are a number of national bodies, such as the Knowledge Share Platform from Netval in Italy, Réseau Curie in France has one, and the Invention Store from Tech Alliance in Germany, just three examples. So what we're trying to do is talk to these players and really work at how we as the EPO can push for a much larger knowledge share platform. And now I'd like to pass over to Enrico to talk about our internal stakeholders.
So yes, Tom, thank you very much for this quite clear outline on our tech transfer activities. As Tom already said, recommendation 3 and 4, so facilitation of technology transfer and cross-networking, so in cooperating with other organizations, are closely intertwined. But we are not only projected towards the outside. Before we move to the outside, I'd like to tell you something about what we're doing inside. So technology transfer is not something we are busy with in Directorate 542 and Principal Directorate 54 Patent Knowledge. There are other internal stakeholders, namely the European Patent Academy. They provide a number of courses which also touch upon technology transfer. They also organize events which are directly connected to technology transfer, and we cooperate closely with our colleagues of the Academy. And the Chief Economist Unit, you might have seen on our website recently, 3 technology transfer case studies were published, 3 others are in the pipeline, a number of studies which have direct contact and connection with technology transfer have also been prepared and will be prepared by the Chief Economist Unit. So just to say, technology transfer is, as Tom said right at the beginning, part of our mission statement. It's not our core business, but we are, as an office, very busy with it and committed to it. So now, having a look at the external stakeholders, what are we doing? Well, we have been cooperating with external stakeholders for years now as EPO, but now we would like to tighten those connections, that cooperation. And we are defining closer cooperation with a number of relevant players in the field. And just to name a few, ASTP, the Association of Technology Transfer Professionals in Europe. We are discussing with them a number of issues. We are at the stage of discussing the possibility of arriving at a memorandum of understanding. We are in close contact with WIPO. And in the MOU we have with them, there is a part completely devoted to a work plan, cooperation between PatLibs and DISCs. We'll come to this in a moment. We are also in close contact with the national technology transfer associations like Netval, that Tom already mentioned, Praxis Orin, and we want to expand that to other national associations. And via ISTP, we are doing that via the National Association Committee. Talking about PatLibs and DISCs, you might know DISCs have a geographical outreach which is different to ours. DISCs are based all over the world, not in Europe. In Europe, we have the PatLib, but the two networks are quite similar, and we want to bring the two networks closer cooperation between one another and sharing experiences. Tom said not only best practices, but practices, experiences in general that can be very useful. Shared training, we are looking into this. And last point, training awareness. We want to discuss with these stakeholders possibility of co-organizing training, sharing training material, cooperating in IP and technology transfer awareness initiatives, and so forth. Of course, talking about external stakeholders, talking about the European Patent Office, we cannot forget, and especially we do not want to forget, the European Commission is one of our main partners. We are in close contact with two Directorate Generals, which to our knowledge are those most involved in technology transfer, the JRC, Joint Research Center, and RTD, Research and Innovation. And with them, we are discussing a number of initiatives. For instance, there will be the upcoming PATLIP conference in May. It will be co-organized with the European Commission. Then, of course, European IP Help Desk, Enterprise Europe Network. Some PATLIPs are part also of these networks. European Innovation Technology Institute and the European Innovation Council, just to name a few. But, of course, cooperation with the European Commission is pivotal to all our initiatives in this field. And last in the list, but certainly not last as importance, and really showing how connected, overlapping technology transfer and outreach to other organizations is, cooperation with other organizations, is the topic of professional accreditation landscape. So accreditation of the technology transfer profession. We are having a look at what was and is out there. UKTS is a project which seems no longer active, but there are some experiences we may be useful. RTTP is, as its main sponsor, ASTP, another organization. CLP is another certification scheme for technology transfer professional. What are we doing there with these partners, stakeholders? We want to promote the technology transfer, and to do this, we need valuable and very robust and experienced and expert professionals. And so therefore, we as EPO would like to have a more relevant role in this landscape, and that's why we are starting talks with these organizations to see how we can promote this certification scheme. And we are looking internally at to how to move forward after we have, having spoken to these partners. So on that, I would give the word floor back to Tom for a summary of what we just said. Tom?
Thank you, Enrico. So to summarize our presentation, what we're really looking for here at the EPO is we want to have much closer cooperation with SMEs and with university technology transfer offices. And for this, the PatLab network is key to make this better connection. We want to reinforce our cooperation with players in intellectual property and the tech transfer field. This is through our external collaborations, for example, with the European Commission. And we really want to strengthen the role, the technology transfer role of our PatLab centers, really bringing them, making them stronger so we can really commercialize what the amazing innovations is going on in Europe. So thank you very much for listening to our presentation. If you have any queries or questions, please feel free to contact us. Our email addresses are on the screen. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.